The best way to read a file depends on what you'd like to do with the file. If you need to read a large file, but you're only interested in some of the lines, not all of them, you could read the file in a for loop, one line at a time, process the line, or skip it, and move on to the next line. We've seen an example of this earlier in the course. This approach leads to memory-efficient and fast code. Another option is to read the entire file in one go. In this case, we'll be doing that because we do not need to skip over any lines in the file. Before you start working with files, make sure that your Python working directory corresponds to the directory where you downloaded your files. You can type pwd, which stands for print working directory, in your IPython shell. And in this case, I do need to move to a different directory. CD stands for change directory. I'm going to go to Python case studies. Then I'll issue CD again. I want to go to the translation case study. I can now say pwd again, and my working directory has now been changed. Now let's read the file. Let me first specify the name of the input file. I'm going to call that variable input file, and in this case it's dna.txt. I'll then be using the open function to open the input file. The second argument is r, which is short for reading. I want to capture the file object here. I'm going to call that f. And finally, I can use the f.read method to read the entire file. I want to make sure that I capture the contents of that file. In this case, what I'm reading is a sequence, so I'm going to call that variable seq. So seq equals f.read. I want to move this code here in my editor for later use. And now we can look at the sequence. You can either say print seq, or you can just type seq. So it looks like the reading operation was successful. If you look carefully, you can see some additional characters in the text. It looks like backslash n appears in the text with some frequency. This is a special character that affects the way the string gets printed, and we ended up with these extra characters because we copy-pasted the text from a web browser to the editor. You can see how these characters affect the way the string is printed by asking Python to print the data. So we type print seq, and you see that the data appear differently on the screen. These extra characters will cause problems for translation. So how could we remove them? An easy way is to use the replace method, which takes two arguments. It replaces every occurrence of the first argument, a substring, with the second argument, another substring. We can type seq.replace. The first is going to be backslash n. That's what gets replaced. And we'll replace that with nothing. Because strings are immutable, the method returns a new string. So in order for us to use the new string, we need to assign it to a variable. In this case, I'm going to reassign it to the same variable as before. We'll take the same command we had before. I'll just type seq equals seq.replace. Let's try printing seq. And in this case, we do not have those extra line breaks that we had there before. Let me take this line of code and move it up to the editor for future use. Sometimes there may be another character hiding in a string, and depending on your computer, it may or may not be visible. Just to be on the safe side, let's remove that as well. There's no harm in running this extra step, because if you don't have the extra character, nothing happens. We'll be using the same command as before, but in this case, we will be removing the backslash r character, and we'll replace that with nothing. I will again take and copy paste this line here, and we're ready to move on.